people say that we don't know English.
Members of the United Church of God at Kosele, Kenya, have taken an initiative to provide schooling and food for orphans in their community. These children have lost their parents due typically to AIDS, and they depend on our members to provide them with sustenance as well as education during the day. The initiative really is born on the backs of a few widows and other church members there who grow the crops, try to build these mud buildings, but the buildings really are inadequate and they struggle to try to keep the project going.
We have so many children suffering outside. They can't come in to start learning because we don't have enough classroom for them.
In March of 2011, the United Church of God Phoenix held a women's weekend, and part of it was a fundraiser for this school.
We held a women's enrichment weekend where we had seminars for the ladies. We had nearly 100 ladies that came. During that weekend, we held a fundraiser, just the ladies. And LifeNets will match, so that amount will double. The funds were raised and donated to Kosele Orphans School in order to provide a more substantial classroom for the teachers and for the students.
I thank you very much for the donation. I will build the classroom here for the children. We are beginning to make bricks for school.
How many will you make before you fire these?
3,000.
Here in Kosele, we have 72 orphans children. We are trying to feed them. We are trying to do so, but we can't make it.
In this region, it was very dry in the past, and at least now we experience some little rain. We could walk for around 10 kilometers looking for water.
We are doing the projects of groundnuts, but some days back we have some drought. We don't have anything now to feed our children. So please, Pastor, can you bring our request there to get something to feed our children here?
Nose to smell, mouth to talk, and tongue to taste, and tongue to taste.
Mother in the kitchen?
Mother in the kitchen, preparing a coffee and some chapati. I like